Record, yep, I'm recording. Good. Okay. So this is a question. I wanted your thoughts on attending social events post-COVID. And now that things are reopening, lots of friends want to do social events, including stag do's. I believe lots of these would involve excessive drinking and possibly low energy locations like nightclubs. What would your thoughts be on attending versus not attending? I can see spiritual merit in both, but can't decide whether it's more important to serve friends by attending and potentially disappointing them by not getting involved with drinking or transcending altogether. Yeah, so that's a pretty clear question for someone who's quite an advanced spiritual seeker. Okay, so with this, I mean, there's context, and please do pray and meditate and ask for guidance to come through yourself, and just take anything that might be useful, more to say. I would say, so generally, if you're familiar with the vibration, if like, you know, high vibration environments, low vibration environments, environments where there's lots of drink and drug taking, environments where there's like gangster rap music playing in the background, and you know, young men usually, even, you know, from office parties, when they leave work, they often like to go a bit OTT, like go into almost seedy environments. I know, having worked in the stock market, there it was like, yeah, well, let's go lap dancing clubs or whatever, seedy environments, and with very low energies and all kinds of negative behavior and thoughts. Now, I would say, generally speaking, I see the difficulty because these are your fellow colleagues at work. And, you know, you don't want to like, you don't want to, well, one way would be to serve them. You're going there as an act of service. The thing I would say is that, you know, if everyone's drinking and you're not drinking, all your office colleagues are drinking, you're not drinking, or if they're all eating donuts and you're not eating donuts, then you tend to get what I call peer pressure, like have a drink and join the gang. And if, you know, if they start drinking or drugging or something, then usually it's into gossip and sort of office politics and gossiping. And don't you think this person at work's terrible? And did you hear that they're going out with so-and-so? And what do you think? Don't you agree they're a horrible person? So, you know, the energy goes into things. So it can be, can get, you know, and people's ugly side may come out in these environments. Also, some of these environments, no, I'm not saying all of them, but if you go to the really seedy places, then you can actually get people who are so intoxicated, you get negative spirits and things wafting around in the thing. So you can get hit, people could get taken over. I'm not saying that would happen, that would be an extreme situation, but with extreme intoxication, all kinds of negative energies can abound, both people in body and also energies out of body. So thing about, you know, there is a thing, yes, so certainly the Holy Spirit may keep you safe because your intention is to serve and love your fellows and see Christ in your fellows. So having such an intention, but generally speaking, I would, I mean, like in the 12-step groups, you know, you're told if you've got a problem with donuts or alcohol and you're an addict, you have to say no. Because just to say yes to make people happy, like have a vodka, just join the gang, that can be saying yes to a gateway to hell, basically. Because in order just to keep your spiritual connection going to grace, you've got to decline that no matter what. So, but that may not be the case if you're not an addict. But still, I would say when you say yes to an event which is going to be of a low vibration in a low vibration setting where people are doing low vibrations, it's usually to come through unscathed without your vibration being dented is quite advanced. You know, if people are drinking and saying have donuts and have a vodka, and let's talk about gossip for 3 hours together and how horrible people are at work. it's a hard environment to keep your vibration up and not get pulled in by the collective. So generally speaking, I wouldn't. Now, I mean, there are other ways. I think, of course, you don't want to piss your colleagues off and be seen as the one who doesn't join in with a drink on the party, on party night. I do understand that. So I would do a lot of prayer. Can you connect with colleagues in a different way? Like, I think it's okay to make white lies. Like, I'm on a diet. I'm not having donuts, and I'm trying not to drink this year. So maybe, hey, why don't we do like a tea party next Sunday, and everyone's invited, and let's have a good, you know, good connection and listen to some classical music together or something. So and you guys do the rave clubbing on Friday. You know, I do a lot of prayer for them, you know, because they may, you know, I do understand, you know, people go, what's wrong with you? You know, why aren't you joining in? But sometimes there is merit in saying no and praying for fellows and finding a different way, a higher way that can keep things going. So that's what I would say. But generally speaking, for me as an addict, you know, I think there has been a lot of pissing people off, but it was necessary, I think, because, you know, if you really need a spiritual connection and the protection of a spiritual connection and you haven't got much in the bank, you have to say no to, you're not strong enough. Of course, if you're like an enlightened guru, you know, there's nothing in the world that can pull you down. It's an interesting, I mean, this idea like, well, it's good for me to transcend the environment, so I'll go in there because I know it will be difficult. Well, again, what is the, I mean, you know, the intention to go and be of service is very high. That is a very high intention, but transcending things and going into difficult environments just for the sake of it, so you can transcend it, I would say you've got to be careful on the motive, because otherwise you might not get the protection if the motive is not very, very high, or the intention is not very high. So I'm wishing you miracles on that. I do understand it's a complicated thing. Trying to be of service, trying to see Christ in others. But I do think there can be things, if everyone's drinking and gossiping for 3 hours and going into potential low vibration, you know, and probably asking you to drink and join in, that can be a difficult environment to come through unscathed. But if you have a high enough intention and you're advanced enough, you may do, or you may go for the benefit of just being of service, which will keep you safe. It should keep you safe. Okay. So wishing you miracles with that.